I'm joined by Ben Allman, who is one of the managers at Whitley Stimpson's High Wycombe branch, and he's going to talk through some very important legislative changes which affect pretty much any small business as far as I'm concerned. We're talking here about anything affecting loans to directors, and various things have changed because of anti-avoidance and things like that. But for all people out there, I think, Ben, it's important we understand even tiny things we used to do just as normal practice, they might be caught by these small changes.
What it really focuses on is when a director takes a loan out from their own company. What the legislation is trying to prevent is directors just treating it like their own petty cash fund. After the company's year end, if that loan is still outstanding, there is a penalty tax of 25%. Some directors have been getting around this by paying back the loan just before the due date. Then, a few days later, after the due date, they take the loan back.
Fantastic. So we've got this key cut-off date, which is 9 months after the end of the year.
That's correct.
And we're saying that if I owe, I don't know, £50,000 2 days before that, there's no charge. Mm-hmm. If I owe £50,000 2 days after that, there's no charge.
Yep.
But if I owe £50,000 on that day, 25% of that figure, 12.5 grand, has to go at the revenue.
That's right.
And okay, so we move the money for a couple of days and put it back in, do we?
As you see, just to avoid that tax, yeah.
Okay.
And of course, there's now a new rule to prevent this. And what that rule says is if there is a loan that has been repaid and then drawn out within 30 days, it's treated as never having been repaid.
Okay, so my 50,000 example, we're saying it was 50 before, it's 50 afterwards. If the gap between the two is shorter than 30 days, it's 50 all the way through.
That's correct.
Okay, so 31 days then, would that work? Do we just extend the period of time and do it that way?
Fortunately, there's new rules as well to prevent that.
Okay.
If the loan is repaid and there are arrangements or even an intention to draw back that loan, then the revenue are going to treat it as having never been repaid.
Wow, so this intention idea, that's when we're looking at perhaps past experience and things like that. Are we always just run up a loan through the year, then pay it off, run up a loan through the year, then pay it off?
Absolutely, they're looking for patterns.
Okay. And obviously, I was reading somewhere that this affects people with sort of large mortgages, interest-only mortgages. I guess this is the point, isn't it? You've paid the money into the company, or you've paid it back, if you like, your loan, but everybody knows you're going to withdraw it again because you've got your mortgage to pay. So it could catch an awful lot of people.
Yeah.
And I guess the point is they need to come and have a chat with
you
guys.
Well, they need to come and see us if they're at all worried about it and they haven't had a discussion with their current accountant about it. We'll come and have a look.
Okay, so this could affect any small business, couldn't it, with directors, taking the money out, using it for their benefit without having a structure of salary or dividends,
absolutely,
things like that, and all the sort of ins and outs and detail, go and see Ben and his colleagues and they should be able to help you out.